think about, you're trying to connect to the source, the creator, you're trying to connect to God and worship. That's what worship is for, is to create a connection point, to acknowledge who God is and what he's done, to celebrate that he's still creating, to celebrate that he's still as awesome as he always was, to align, you know, your spirit, your mind, and your body to the reality of who God is and his nature. You're going to be visited by that nature. You're going to be touched by that nature, and there's going to be a flow of inspiration no matter what. And it may not happen all at once. I mean, it's progressive. Sometimes it's accumulative. Sometimes it's changing your culture before it's a mental and intellectual change. It's a spiritual and emotional change. I mean, there's people who start crying in worship. They don't know why. But if you look at why they're worshiping to connect to the God who is still alive and who is still source. And so he's outsourcing their emotions and their spirit and installing and imparting. And it's kind of like everybody has a computer, and at some point it needs to be updated, whether it's a Mac or a PC or whatever, it has to be updated. And most of us like say, delay, I don't want to update today, it takes too long, I have to do everything else. And when you worship, you're literally saying, okay, reset, go ahead, upgrade my processor, upgrade everything that needs to be upgraded. You're stopping for a moment and allowing your whole processor and who you are to be, you know, attuned and in tune and upgraded. And I just think that worship is an upgrade. It's an experience of tuning you into the perfection of who God is. And there's an output that comes no matter what because of that. And so the more you worship, the more in-tuned you get. The less you worship, the more you're left to some inspiration or some creativity inside of you that doesn't continue in the source of it. And so a lot of people get like writer's block or music block or whatever because they're not going back to the source of where it came from. But if you have a plug in your hand and you plug it into the source, you know, your batteries only last so long. You plug in the source and you stay plugged in, man, not only are you recharged, but if you stay plugged in, it's done. I mean, you'll have permanent energy. I have felt like there's times when something outside of myself, I channeled, and you know, through me, which is like a creative idea like I started doing this series of door paintings that I'm getting known for, which is really strange because I never wanted to do doors, but I actually texture canvas and put all kinds of stuff into them and get real old door, you know, hinges and whatever, and door and whatever, and I make them look really broken. And they're these doors that, and I feel when I'm doing them, it's not coming from my ideas. I would have never done doors, but when I start to look at a canvas, I see a door. You know, I used to think like I was a servant to creativity, and I was looking for how do I partner to something above? There's a greater idea than me and what I would have. And now I look at it, I am friends with a young girl named Akiana, who's an artist. And I went to her studio, and she's one of the top 20 artists in the world right now. And I went to her studio and I was watching her. I got to hang out with her while she was painting this one painting. She was doing an original self-portrait that she did when she was around 12 years old. She's older now. And she was painting, and it was her painting the stars. And she said, I had to realize I'm not just serving a creativity, but I'm actually a co-creator with God, and that there's something inside of me that agrees with the nature of God, something inside of him. And it emulates, but it doesn't just reflect it, it creates with him, and I'm called to be a creator for all eternity. And something when she said that, I went, you know what, I'm an originator, I'm not just serving something. I'm not just limited to God's ideas coming into me and I'm possessed by God and all of a sudden I'm doing something. I'm actually like, he's given me the power of original thought and original ideas. And I believe somehow that God broke off a part of himself and created 7 billion human souls. And in that we actually inspire God too, because it's part of his nature that we're stewarding, that we have free will over. That we create something that he didn't anticipate us creating. Maybe he could foresee it, maybe he knows what it looks like long term, but the angels are in awe. They didn't know that that was gonna come from us. They didn't know that symphony, they didn't know that was gonna come.